We are back. Hopefully everybody had good holidays. If Artifact Anvil or Prismatic Finale, I'm down with either of them. I'm only going to vote for one if somebody else votes for like larger legends, which somebody did. So I will vote for the one with less people right now. Definitely had Blossom coming in hot there at the beginning over here. She jumps up onto this desk so hard that it shakes the desk whenever she does it. Vex? I mean, that's emo if I want it, but probably getting sold. We just have a super fan opener. It's not the best, but it's probably just fine. I'm going to put Inkin in for now, and then I'll probably end up buying this. I think it's good enough just to get that free early item. Titan's Resolve, gold. All right, I'll buy it. Get in there, Lilia. Now I just have to figure out what else I'm playing. And I know I'm holding Kennen Bear. Could play Cassante for Sentinel. MF? Oh, okay. Need to hit 10 there. Escort Quest is interesting. That's also very good. Very good early. Look around. Lots of Lilia headliners. Escort Quest does not seem very good here. I could go for That's Jazz Baby. I'm down. Good thing is, I wish I had that MF still. That would be insane. I could level. I am going to level just to throw in Cassante. And I'm going to win this because this guy is full opening for sure. So I will hold the extra Cassante. This Kai'Sa would be very good if I had something to go with it. I'd like to get to where I'm obviously gaining sooner rather than later. That makes things like Psycho leveling a little bit better. I'm just going to hold Kai'Sa for now. I think my best unit here is probably just the fact that I have Kennen too this early. I wish I still had that MF, but I had to sell it there. I don't think there's any way I can keep it. I have to sell it and just hit 10. I'm probably close to being able to keep it. Oh, I hit a gold. Get your ults off Bard and we win for sure. We got it. Jinx 2 does not help me here. I can hit 20. All right, I'm probably losing to this guy. Superfan. The other ones I'm okay against. I would love an Echo here. Echo or MF on Carousel are probably my best two options. Probably by a large margin too. I am going to keep this win, which means I get to level next turn and still be above 20. So our econ's great here. There's an Echo with a belt. I'd be super down for that, and I could just build Sunfire. Other than that, there's a sword on a Bard, which is good. Nico Cloak, also good. I think Belt Echo is my best. I want Nico Cloak then. I'm definitely leveling here. Throw in KDA as well. Now we'll start gaining health. Could also just go ahead and give her a Stone Plate. Try and keep the win streak alive. If I win, I will sell these off to hit 30. But now we're starting to stack just max health on Bard, which not great, obviously, but it's okay. The big thing is getting to where we stack attack speed and AD on MF. I'm going for MF Jazz Carry this time around. I played Bard recently, so I don't want the same comps over and over again. Oh, that was barely a win. Hit 30 real quick. Bard pair, I'm definitely holding. I'm going to swap sides last second because this guy's all left-sided, and I want him to target Lilia first, just in case. Which we didn't end up fighting him, but we're definitely beating this board. 4 Sentinel with no upgrades. I will need to find a replacement Lilia at some point. Yeah, I'll definitely need to find replacement Lilia at some point. So we both got to 5 streak. Even got some stacks there. 5 Edgelord. I might have beaten him. Last Whisper is good. That's definitely what I'm down for. Belt, Cloak, Even Shroud. Oh, okay. Bard 2 and MF in the same shop. Throw this MF in. Now we have 5 traits, which means we start gaining attack speed immediately. I can slam both my items. Yeah, this feels very good. Still need my replacement Lilia. Right now, I'm just playing to try and hit level 8. I'll roll at 8 for MF. I could roll at 7 still. But hitting one of the 5 costs is also so big. And we did get the Yasuo guy this time. I don't think we beat him. We don't, because he's going to get my MF. Then the Bard next. Oh, that's bad. It was close. It's definitely a loss, though. Tiny Titans? No. Not Parting Gifts, either. Healing Orbs is just super safe here. Actually, I'm going to take Blistering Strikes. Get another Bard there. I will for sure need a Misfortune and Echo. Like, I need MF to keep gaining these stacks, but I need an Echo over everything right now. Just because Echo is just so good in this comp. You immediately get two traits out of it every time. And right now my MF1's at 0.97 attack speed. Ahri is interesting here, but I don't think I'm actually supposed to play it. Because if I play it, then I have to remove Big Shot, which makes me stop losing the 2% or stop gaining 2% attack speed, which is just bad. Oh, this guy has gotten definitely stronger since the last time we fought him. I want Sword over everything on Garrosel. Go Stoneblade value. Our Stoneblade's getting max value right now. Oh, and we are going to win. Okay. Did not think I was winning this fight earlier. I want Sword, Bow, or Glove here. If possible. Bow is the most flexible, so I'd like that over everything. Okay, sweet. I'm getting Bow. 0.98 attack speed. Am I leveling? I can add in Sentinel. And if I'm keeping my win streak up to 4, it would be worth it. And I can still stay at 50 if I win the fight. I'm putting the Bow probably on MF. Yeah, especially if the fight's iffy. The fight looked like it wasn't iffy and like an auto win, I don't have to slam it, but I have to slam it if it looks iffy. This is the same guy from earlier, the double Adapticone. And he is gonna beat me. I'm gonna sell Kai'Sa to stay above, because since Kai'Sa's not gonna be in my end comp. Kane. Alright, I'm gonna sell, I think. Yeah, because as long as I'm still staying above 5 unique traits, I'm down to sell. Then I can just put these items... I don't know. I'll just hold them for a turn. Maybe I roll here. But Kane seems very good here, too. I'll roll to find my MF headliner, at least, so I can stay fairly strong. If Bard would just target that same unit, target the Corki, we would win this fight. Alright, roll time. There's an Echo, not the one I'm looking for, though. Country Samira? Why you gotta do that to me, game? There's an MF2. I'm definitely gonna lock the shop. That's a lot of bows. There's an Echo. Alright, this gets me into 7 traits. I need to sell this off. Big Shot MF, is that good enough? Probably. Also, what am I doing with all this? Probably building 2 items here. I'm just gonna throw a cloak there. I feel like I need to take the Big Shot MF. Yeah, I'll play it and then just take, or play 2 Jazz. Talent Search actually isn't terrible here. I'm not taking Uplink. I'm a big fan of stationary support. I'm just going to take stationary support. Zephyr, ZZ Rot. Also, we're 2 off of the MF3. 1.12. I feel like she's not a great holder for a red buff. Like, I could just go, since it's Big Shot, I could just put the red buff on Ezreal later and then just put the red buff on Kai'Sa right now. And then plan on leveling, throwing in another Kai'Sa. I'm down for that. Now we can start gaining AD as well. I am going to keep rolling here, though. Just because I'm so close to just having the MF3. There's a Bard. And a Nico, which I actually do need to start picking up. I could roll pretty deep here if I wanted. Let's look around. Anyone playing Jazz? I don't see Jazz in anyone's comp. This guy has 8-bit and Big Shot. Oh, no. He has an MF headliner. So that's 3. If it's just him, though, I'm not worried. Which it looks like it might be. Yeah, it's just him. So I'm not worried then. Spat? That's a jazz spat. If I can get that, I'll take it immediately. Okay, he took it. Sad day. I have that bow hanging. I probably just want a sword. I'll build Last Whisper, or not Last Whisper, but Giant Slayer, and be happy with it. Also, AD currently at 108. Giant Slayer here. Illaoi? How do I hit Illaoi and Qiyana here? Illaoi is so good. I'm trying to think of how I could best put this in. It would be out Superfan, probably. Go Illaoi set. Qiyana here. That gives me Bruiser. I need to just roll it down, honestly. I'm not going to hold the Qiyana. I'll hold the Illaoi, though. I need to hit this MF3. This guy's still chilling on his Jhin. Or not Jhin, but MF. That's so wild. I don't know how I hit multiple of those. There's one. We're one off. And there's my Ezreal. Another Bard. I'm still debating on this. I don't think I'm playing Qiyana. Also, I went down to 6, which isn't great. Should I take out the super fan? I don't think I can until later. But Ezreal can definitely go in. There's another Bard. I need to level pretty soon. I need to just level and throw in Kai'Sa. I'm going to sell off the Illaoi. It feels bad. It feels very bad. But hitting these units, I think, is just my key to winning the game. Another Stone Plate, another Even Shroud, a blue buff. I mean, blue buff, red buff, Ezreal's okay. Plus Sunfire or Ionic. Okay, yeah, I'm down. All right, I need this. There's a Lilia. Lilia 2, Nico 2, Echo 2. All right, I need to go ahead and put my items onto this Ezreal, though. Red buff, blue buff, Sunfire. And we go with this. I can hit 20 again. I really need that one MF. We're one MF off, two Bards off, which Bard's actually not too huge for me here. MF, though, is absolutely massive. Come on, game. I'm rolling it down to 0 and missing. There she is. The MF3. Now I just need to play to level. I need to play to level and then throw Kai'Sa in. So I'll need to find a new Kai'Sa, which kind of sucks. We did kill the Yone there, which is good, but we're not stacking AD right now because we're only at 5. We're just stacking more attack speed. Any KDA unit will actually do. It doesn't have to be Kai'Sa, but Kai'Sa is going to be the best in the long term because then I'll get 4 Big Shot in. Middle. Let's go more towards the middle with this and see what happens. Like, hitting that Poppy would be insane. Hitting Echo here is great. All right, Blitzcrank, get out of here. What are you doing? You can't be on my back line. The Kali, that's all she does. So that's a little different. Ahri with that single target damage. Okay, we got it. It's fine. I would love TG here. TG Bard. Okay, he took the TG. I could blue buff Bard. That's not very good. I'm just going to go Giant Slayer. Just Giant Slayer my Bard, since I think Bard is going to be 3-starred. I could also just Giant Slayer the Ezreal, and that could just be as good. Let's check my damage from last round. He's already dealing double my Bard, but my Bard's also gaining the stacks, so I should probably put it there. No, what if I do hit a TG later? I'm going to finish the items here. If I hit a TG later, it's just so much better that I don't have any items here. Well, we hit that guy's Blitzcrank. Oh, is this going to stun my MF? Oh, it didn't. Okay. If it stuns my MF, that's really bad. He's on Ezcarry? That was close. The real worry for me is that I haven't even seen another KDA unit. KDA or Dazzler. I'm going to roll once and hit one. That's the best one. Ezreal can sit here since he kind of has that natural avoid. And I did... it's a 50. I missed the 50. I was hoping to hit that Poppy. I'm back to stacking my AD though. Which is very important here. Okay, guys. Go MF. MF 1v3. She actually survived. Okay. Oh. That guy has 7 poppies. The koi fish has 7 poppies. The koi fish has 7 poppies. This guy has extra Ari. Nothing. 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 Okay. I was just seeing if anyone else was going for something crazy. We are kind of capped here, though, for now. Reforger, gold, TG. That's what I'm talking about. I will happily take a TG. I can fight the Yone player or this guy or this guy. So I think it's probably better for me to swap here to try and hit the Yone. Let's see if he moves. He didn't move. So if I do fight him, okay, I don't. Unfortunate. I would have much rather fought him. These Thieves Gloves items aren't bad this round, though. I want to see how much AD she is at the end of the last fight. Right now, I mean, she's dealing 7.5k, but my Ezreal 1 almost dealt 5k. And there's Ezreal 2, which is even better. I can swap these two because she also has that natural evade. Dazzler or just Lucian are my next best things. At level 9, I'm probably not hitting level 9 though. Is anyone doing craziness? This guy's one off of Poppy 3. Please take him out. Why do I not fight the guy that I'm aiming for with my Zephyr? If only. She has 1.37 attack speed and almost 350. Well, see that 394 AD, but I don't think that's the actual one. 327 or 236. Okay. Well, perfect items for my Bard. You see that? Everybody loves Tank Bard. Oh, it's a 1v1. Okay. Well, now I'm definitely just supposed to buy things, right? I have one more fight, maybe. He did move last second. Moved the Yone. 329 AD. He is level 9. I'm never hitting level 9 this game. That's guaranteed. But the earlier I target this Yone, the better it is for me. I am going to beat him. Nice. Nice. That's Jazz, baby. There's a true damage emblem, KDA emblem, even shroud. I'm going to take the Bloodthirster, actually. Oh, you're just going to let me hit the Bard 3 like that for free? Now there's nothing for me to roll to. All right, I'm going to reforge this. I changed my mind. A DB. DB awkwardly on Kinnan because of the bling bonus. I can still swap to that side if I really want to hit this. I'm going to move it last second, see if... okay, he still moved. So he is trying to play around my Zephyr. Trying to play around it as much as he can, it looks like. He did stun me that time. Oh, what? The 35 health Kale? There's no way for me to level. There's also no way for him to actually hit here. Hit anything different. I was just seeing if I could maybe hit Ezreal 3. Swap sides again. Did I get him this time? I might have got him this time. I didn't. I thought I got him. Did get better items on the Bard, though. No tank Bard. No tank Bard this round. GG! We got there. That is Jazz, baby. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to let me know down below.